Before selecting the standards, it is important to understand the differences in the available assessment modes and standards. It is recommended that you review the tutorial on the assessment mode or read the help information for that topic before proceeding. The Security Assurance Level, or SAL, is a general measurement of how much rigor is required to protect the cyber and control systems at your facility. As expected, if an incident occurred, a facility with a low level would have less risk and less severe consequences than a facility with a high or very high level. This also means that the security requirements will be more stringent for organizations at the higher levels. The overall SAL is set to moderate by default, but it can be changed by picking a different value. If you do not know what the level should be for your organization, you can find it using either the general or NIST SAL determination methods. The individual levels under confidentiality, integrity, and availability are used in the CNSSI 1253 analysis and can also be overridden here. The general SAL approach is consequence-based and recommends a level based on the impact to the organization, community, and surrounding environment. We will look at this approach first. To determine your SAL, simply read the question, then move the slider bar across to the range that matches your best estimate of the impact. You need to do this for both the on-site and off-site options. To better understand the question, you can open the help information associated with each question. You will notice that as you move the bars, the overall level dynamically changes. Click on the OK button to close and return to the standard screen. You will notice that the SAL has been updated to moderate, based on settings in the General SAL screen. We will now use the NIST SAL method to determine our security level. First, click on the Start button. There are three steps in this process. The first is to understand the approach and supporting documentation. To see a quick overview of the process, click the hyperlink titled Read the NIST Guide. If you have not studied the actual NIST documents, then click on the hyperlinks to access and read them. Reading the documents is not required, but it is highly recommended. The second step is to select the information types that are associated with your organization. We will select several as an example. You will notice that as the information types are selected, the fields in each of the categories of confidentiality, integrity, and availability all dynamically change based on the type selected. You should review all information types and mark the ones appropriate for your organization. If you have questions about a type, be sure to open the NIST documents and review the respective section. The final step is to answer a small set of questions to determine if the value should be increased based on response. Read the questions and answer each one as a yes or no. A yes answer will always increase the level in one or more categories. The screen shows the levels in each category and the overall NIST level. To close this screen, click the OK button on the bottom. You will notice that the fields have been updated based on our selections and answers in the NIST SAL screen. These values will be used to limit or expand the questions in the standards depending on the SAL, the assessment mode, and the standard selected.